गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर इन मैथ्स, दैट इज सिक्स्थ चैप्टर इंडाइसेस। चिल्ड्रन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड यू ऑल आर कंप्लीटिंग योर गिवन असाइनमेंट ऑन टाइम। टुडे योर एमसीक्यू बेस्ड एग्जाम इज देयर। आई होप यू ऑल प्रिपेयर फॉर योर एग्जाम। So children, here in sixth chapter indices we are going to learn multiplication, addition of the same number again and again can be shown as multiplication. What do you mean by that? Addition of the same number. Here I had written some numbers, that number is 5. The addition of same number means 5, again and again I had written same number, then can be shown as multiplication. Same thing, 5 how many times written? 1 2 3 4 5 6, means the same number, that is 5, I had written how many times? That is 6 times. You will get 5 6 30. Same thing, when you will add 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 5 15, 15 plus 5 20, 20 plus 5 25, 25 plus 5 30. Means in both the condition, you will get the same number. So children, one thing is this one, other one, base and index. Now, which one we had added and multiplied? What and how we are getting? Here see, the number 5, I had multiplied 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times. Multiplication of 5, 6 times. So, 5 is multiplied by itself 6 times. So, it's written as 5 raised to 6. Here, we are writing like this way. Which number again and again we had written? That is same. That is 5. And how many times we had written? 6 times. That's why 5 raised to 6. This is the index form of the multiplication. Now 5 raised to 6. 5 is called the base. This 5 is called the base. And 6 is called index. And it's read as 5 raised to 6. So children, related to indices, the basic things you learned. Now, we will move to our further exercise in this chapter. So, here exercise number exercise number 26. So children, column is given in your question number first. First column, it's given serial number, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, like this way. Second column given indices, that is number or in index form. For example, question number first, 3 raised to 4. Base is asking, write down base equal to 3. Index equal to 4. Okay? Now next one, multiplication form. Multiplication form. Here, multiplication form, that is 3, how many times multiplied? 4 times. Now next column, value. Children, you will draw the column and you will complete. Here I had not drawn the column, I had given the statement and giving the answer. Value, Now 3 into 3, 3 3 jar 9, 9 3 jar 27, 27 3 jar 81. For 3 raised to 4, your value is 81. So children, this one is question. Base, first one base, second one index, third one multiplication form of question, and fourth one value. I hope you understood the given sum properly. Now next sum. Question number second. Question given 16 raised to 3. So children, here base equal to base. I am not writing full. I had written B only. Base equal to 16. Index equal to 3. Multiplication form equal to 16, how many times? 3 times. 16 into 16 into 16. Now value. Value equal to 16 into 16. 256. Suppose you want to find out the answer, multiply 16 into 16. 6 6 jar 36. 6 1 jar 6. 6 plus 3 9. 1 into 6, 6, 1, 1, jar, 1, 5 and 2. Your answer is 256, but we don't want 256. We want 16 into 16 into 16. That's why again we will multiply 256 into 16. Then 6, 6, jar, 36, 6, 5, jar, 30. 30 plus 3, 33. 6, 2, jar, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 1 into 6, 6. 1 into 5, 5. 1 into 2, 2. 6, 9, 10. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 4. Answer is 4, 0, 9, 6. So children, in this way, we will solve the sum. Now, question number fourth. Question number fourth is given little bit in different way. That is in fraction way. Question number fourth. Three, first one. Index form not given. Question not given. Base is asking. Index is asking. But multiplication form is given. And value is also given. Then with the help of multiplication form, we can find out the question. For example, question. Question. What is and base? Base. And index. So multiplication and base. Base will be 3 raised to 7. Index means how many times the same number multiplied. Here same number 3 by 7 multiplied by 4 times. That's why your index will be 4. Now question. Then write down 3 upon 7 raised to 4. Is it clear? We had collected multiplication form. From there base and how many times the same number is multiplied. From that we got base and index. Once we get base and index, it is easy to write the question. So children, I hope related to question number first, you all are able to complete the table. Now, question number second, find the value. Here, in question number second, directly asking the value. So, first one, 2 raised to 10. First question, 2 raised to 10. So, children, 2 multiplied by how many times? 10 times. 2 into 2 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Then we are going to multiply. 2 2 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 8 2 jar 16, 16 2 jar 32, 32 2 jar 64. Till here we had multiplied, that is 64. Next one, 2 2 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 8 2 jar 16. 64 into 16. 6 4 jar 24, 6 6 jar 36, 37, 38. 1 4 jar 4, 6 1 jar 6. Answer 4. 8 plus 4, 12. 6 plus 3, 9. 9, 1, 10. Answer is 1, 0, 2, 4. Is it clear? Now, we will solve next question. That is question number 2, 5 raised to 3. How many times 5? 3 times. 5, 5 jar 25. 25, 5 jar 125. Next question. Minus 7 raised to 4. Third one. Minus 7 raised to 4. So children, here in base, minus 7 given. Don't worry. You all learned in second chapter. That is minus 7 into minus 7 into minus 7 into minus 7. That how many times? 4 times. 7, 7 jar 49. And minus minus plus. Next one. 7, 7 jar 49. And this minus minus plus. Means now here no minus sign is there. So children, 49 into 49. You are going to multiply. Then what will be your answer? You will write 49 into 49. Multiply and write down. Multiply 49 into 49 and write the answer. I hope you all are able to multiply the given sum and you will write the answer. In the same way, we will solve one fraction type sum. So children, here fraction type question. So children, here we had written the question number 7th one. 4 upon 5 raised to 3. So, base is given, base is 4 upon 5, index is 3, as earlier we have studied. So, children, 4 upon 5 into 4 upon 5 into 4 upon 5. How many times? 3 times. So, 4, 4 jar, 16, 4, 4 jar 16, 16 into 4, 64. 5, 5 jar 25, 25, 5 jar 125. So, for 4 upon 5 raised to 3, your answer is 64 upon 125. So children, next question, 8th one, minus 1 upon 2 raised to 4. So here, base is minus half, that is minus 1 upon 2 is base, 4 is index. Then how many times we will write 1 upon 2? Of course, you all learned this chapter. That's why you all are able to give the answer. Minus 1 upon 2 into minus 1 upon 2. How many times? 4 times. So children, here we had completed. How many times? 4 times. We will multiply. When we will multiply 1 in numerator, always 1 multiply by 1, we will get 1 only. Next one, 2 2 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 8 2 jar 16. Means in denominator we got 16. Now question is there, what about our minus sign? Minus, minus, plus, plus, minus, 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 plus. So children, here, suppose you don't know, then minus, minus, plus, these two you got. Minus sign, plus. Here also minus, minus, plus. Plus, plus, plus. Whatever you will do and the, whatever method you will apply, you will get plus sign only in your answer. That's why no need to worry. Now question exercise, practice set 27. practice at 27. Here, in practice at 27, question is given, simplify. It's very simple. 7 raised to 4 into 7 raised to 2. So children, as you all are seeing, our base, that is 7, in both the place, base is same. Then what you will do? Children, in your textbook page number 45, one formula is given. If A is a rational number and M and N are positive integer, then that is, we are writing like this way, A raised to M into A raised to N equal to, here also you all are seeing that base is same. That's why I write down base as same and index you will add. M plus N, because index is different number. Here also in your given question, base is same. You will write base same. Index 4 plus 2 as we had written over here. Put this box in, put this formula in one box. Next one, 7 raised to 4 plus 2, that is 7 raised to 6. You got? I hope you all understood. Now we will solve next sum, question number 2. So children, minus 11 raised to 5 into minus 11 raised to 2. In one line also you can complete, that is base is same only. Index 5 plus 2 minus 11, index is 7. Next one, we will solve one fraction like sum. For example, sixth one we will solve. P upon 5 raised to 3 into P upon 5 raised to 7. So children, here we all are seeing base is same. We will write base same, P upon 5. After that, index we all are seeing, index is different. 3 plus 7. Then P upon 5, index 3 plus 7 is 10. I hope related to exercise 27, all the sums are depend on the given formula. Which one is, we had written A raised to M into A raised to N equal to A raised to M plus N. Now we will move further to our exercise 28. So children, here in exercise 28 also, it's very easy. Question number first one. In question number first one, that is A raised to 6, first sum, A raised to 6 divided by A raised to 4. So children, here what is there in between? Division sign. But till now what we had studied? Multiplication sign. But here in practice at 28, in between division sign is given. Therefore no need to worry. One formula is given in your textbook, page number 46. What is that formula? If A is a rational number, A is not equal to 0, M and N are positive integer, then AM, I am writing the formula, AM upon AN equal to AM minus N. So, here, related to this formula, we will solve all the given practice at 28. So here, A raised to 6 divided by A raised to 4. This one is same as this one. A raised to 6 upon A raised to 4. Then what we will do? We will write A, that is base same, and we will subtract the index. Then 6 minus 4. Further, a raised to 6 minus 4 answer is 2. Therefore, your answer is a raised to 2. Is it okay? So, children, in our second sum, m raised to 5 divided by m raised to 3. Sorry, m raised to 8. So, m we will write base is same on in both the place. That's why we will write base same. After that, 5 minus 8 equal to m base same. 5 minus 8, that is 3. And which one is greater number? 8. We are subtracting 5 from 8. Therefore, 8 minus 5 answer is 3. And 8 is having minus sign. Therefore, with your answer, you will put minus sign. I hope here, this point, you all understood what we did. We find out that which one is greater number. As we know, 8 is greater number. That's why from 8, we had subtracted smaller number, that is 5. 8 minus 5, 3. After that, we had seen with 8, which sign is there. As you all are seeing, with 8, minus sign is there. That's why in our index, we put minus sign with the answer, that is minus 3. M raised to minus 3. So children, here we will solve question number third one, that is P raised to 3 divided by P raised to 13. Here also same. Base will remain as it is. Index 3 minus 13 P. Then 13 minus 3 answer is 10. And 13 is having minus sign. Therefore, we will put minus sign in our answer. Therefore, answer will be P raised to minus 10. So, children, here question number fourth one, x raised to 10 divided by x raised to 10. So, children, here x 10 minus 10, x raised to 0. 10 minus 10, 0. Then, so student, if any number of base is having index 0, any number or some number, which one, whatever will be, if base is having index 0, then that answer directly we will write 1. Suppose, one example I will give, 5 raised to 0. Here, 5 raised to 0 means we will write directly answer 1. One more example, suppose 20 raised to 0. Directly, index is 0 means directly we will write answer is 1. So, in our question number second. So, children, here in question number second, what is given? Find the value. First one, minus 7 raised to 12 divided by minus 7 raised to 12. So, base is same. We will write minus 7. Index we will subtract 12 minus 12. Base minus 7. And index 12 minus 12, 0. As I told earlier, if base is the given number and index is 0, automatically your value will be 1. So children, next question. 7 raised to 5 divided by 7 raised to 3. Here, 7 base will remain same. Index 5 minus 3. 7 raised to 2. Answer is the 49 or square of 7 equal to 49. Next one. Third one. 4 raised to 5 index 3 divide by 4 raised to 5 index 2. So children, base is same, therefore we will write base 4 upon 5. We will subtract the index 3 minus 2. 4 raised to 5 index is 1. Then value will be automatically 4 upon 5. That is 4 upon 5. In the same way, fourth one. 4 raised to 7 divide by 4 raised to 5. Base is same. That's why children write 4 and in index 7 minus 5. Answer is 2. 4 raised to 2, that is 16. So children, I hope related to this chapter today, whatever the practice set we had completed, you all understood properly. So practice set 26, 27 and 28, all three practice set completed before 1 o'clock and submitted in group, because tomorrow you all are having exam at 1 o'clock. That's why before that you try to complete the assignment and submit it in your group. Be safe, healthy and happy. Thank you, children.